already cake ass nigga, you know what it is. Realest nigga on the gram, bitch ass nigga. And I'm here kicking it with four real niggas. Well, five real niggas. They got a real nigga behind. You got Mo City Red behind the boys. Five. Hey. Podcast, bitch ass nigga. Make sure you tune in, man, because these niggas gonna keep it real. These niggas gonna keep it funny. They gonna keep it real funny, cake ass nigga. And yeah, man, just be on the lookout, because I will be fucking with these niggas. And if you fuck with me, you fuck with these niggas, bitch ass nigga.
I'm on my Twitter timeline.
Uh-oh, breaking news.
No, it ain't no breaking news. I just, all right, I just want y'all's opinion on this. I just saw a scenario tweet. Mm-hmm. There's a video of a young lady giving fellatio to a stripper. And
a video of a young lady giving a fellatio to a stripper.
To a male stripper?
To a male stripper.
She's sucking the dick of the. She's doing a dance bear party.
It says, fellas, this surfaced 2 months after your wedding from your wife's bachelorette party. Are you staying with her or are you divorcing her?
We're getting a divorce.
All right.
You staying with her because there's no videos of your bachelor party because you're smart.
And if you that dumb, I'm getting
my mission failed. We'll get them next time.
So you staying, Method?
Wait, so what? 10 months after I got married, a video shows up of her sucking dick at the bachelor.
4 months.
4 months?
Yeah.
Bro, if a video come out of your bitch at any time in your marriage, you have all grounds to leave.
That's on the internet, fam. It don't get deleted.
It's wait, so, okay, let's ask these. Let's ask. Let's sequence this.
Me, my nigga, you got let's to let that this. Shit
it
go.
It don't matter what you did at your bachelor party, nigga.
Your wife,
how far apart are the bachelor party?
It don't matter.
It does.
Your wife, your wife.
Is there any proof of what you did on your bachelor party?
I don't know, because she probably didn't know this was out there.
It don't matter.
Fuck that.
I don't. Okay,
bitch, you sucked the dick on tape with the wedding gown on your head.
Was it after the rings went on? Was it before the rings went on?
With the bachelor party?
This dick sucking.
It's at the bachelorette party.
How far she has on bride to be?
Talk about.
What I'm saying is,
don't save them.
What I'm saying is,
they don't want to be saved.
Are the bachelorette party? How far apart are the bachelorette parties and the weddings?
Here come Mathis.
All right, so Mathis, typically, I don't know how your situation was, but typically, typically how this works is a bachelorette party happens after an engagement. So there's an engagement. So,
okay, so we're talking about this post engagement stuff.
There's a ring on a finger.
It's a bachelorette party. She got to be engaged.
This nigga's the biggest Johnny Cochran I know. Boy, you bullshitting the shit out of this old ass nigga.
Yeah, bro.
Goddamn, boy, you a bullshit. Nigga, you are goddamn a bachelorette party is before the motherfucking wedding, either nights or weeks prior to.
I need an exact time window. That's why I keep asking.
Motherfucker, the weekend before y'all getting married, she on tape sucking dick.
There is a rock on her ring finger, left hand.
She live with you, nigga. Nigga, she live with you.
That she's jacking it off.
You put that big ass rock on. She's jacking some.
She live with you. She came back home and kissed you that night, motherfucker.
Okay, thank you. There you go. Because Jay knew what I needed.
All right, wait.
No, but she didn't gotta do that.
Hold up.
It's a bachelorette party. She probably didn't go home.
Hold up.
Don't matter.
That's where I was going.
She came back and kissed that.
Nine times out of ten, the bachelorette party is like the night before. Like,
I'm the 10th.
You don't see each other.
I've never been involved with the wedding where the bachelorette party was the day before the wedding.
It don't matter.
Yeah. It don't fucking matter.
It doesn't matter at all.
Okay.
Stop caping.
I'm not caping. If you're really paying attention to this conversation, I'm saying that I ain't shit too. So what I'm asking is,
I don't give a fuck.
So you live by the do as I say, not as I do.
Facts.
Okay. So in that case, I'm leaving because me and DJ are on the same page. Now I understand. Okay, I'm walking with you. Yeah, everybody in this room is leaving. Don't suck dick on camera.
It don't matter what you didn't get caught doing. It matters what she got caught. Am I gone? Am I here?
No, you good.
It don't matter what you didn't get caught doing. It matters what she got caught doing. I don't give a fuck how fucked up that sounds right now, but she got caught on fucking camera.
I've been listening to a lot of them.
I hate everybody she knows at that point.
All
your homegirls.
I got cases on all you bitches right now.
Bruh, I don't know. You might be able to play that back. There's a moment where I'm just appalled, confused,
appalled,
deranged.
Yeah.
Like, I'm just sitting here like, what the fuck?
I got cases on all you bitches.
Ain't about to have no dancing bear parties around me, bitch.
I'm slitting throats. Bitch, I'm out here staking
out. Don't say that.
So, really, you kind of led me to another topic.
All right. What it is.
So, I've been on, you know, just been binge watching and shit because, you know, we just chilling in the cribs. So, there's a show that Math has ruined for me, but I still watch it anyways. It's called For Life.
Oh, funded
for life.
It's by 50 Cent, because you said that every nigga from England sounds like fucking Denzel Washington. And this nigga really sounds like Denzel Washington.
Yes.
So
y'all niggas taking shots.
It just fucks me up. Let's run take another one. Somebody pour it up while I talk, while I give the people the scenario. And just a heads up, if you listen to the homies, they did talk about this already. But you know, it's four niggas, so we're gonna talk about it a little different than one nigga and two girls.
All right, that's enough.
So what happens is they finally give the episode from Shorty's point of view, what happened when this nigga got locked up.
Oh, from a girl? Joy?
Yeah, from Joy Bryant's point of view.
Joy.
So
Joy to be.
Ignorant.
Let's go.
Hey, as ignorant as they are, that's a good song.
Yeah. That was a fucking dope.
That's a classic.
That was an alley.
That's a fire ass song.
So homeboy gets arrested and put in jail for some shit that he didn't do.
Okay.
Allegedly.
He didn't do it.
Allegedly. God damn, Mathis.
What he got? You seen the shit?
God
damn,
what he got caught for? He didn't do it at the audience.
It's still gonna say allegedly.
I'm so far behind.
God damn.
He didn't do it.
Okay.
She stood by a nigga through the trial.
Yeah.
She held it down.
Even when the prosecution threw some shit that was suspect, but he was still like, look, bitch.
When you showed up with this white woman.
I didn't do it.
Are you sure there were no drugs?
Didn't do it. She held that nigga down through like, you know, she was there for the first year, you know, going through all the visitations. Always there. Second year, third year, fourth year, always there. Around year 4 or 5, her family started talking about, you know, you gotta start living your own life. You know, you always wanted to be a nurse. Go to nursing school. Go do this. Go do that.
Visitation like, started slowing down.
My homeboy cousin, a doctor, he could get
To make matters worse. This is not the question. But to make matters worse, around year 7, her daughter has a birthday party and she's feeling lonely. And she confides in this nigga's best motherfucking friend.
Bitch, I'll kill ya.
If I was your best friend.
And she kisses that nigga. But that's not even a question. She was already down bad for that. But she didn't even tell that nigga that part of it. She shows up in year 7 to visitation with the manila folder for the divorce papers.
She gonna marry my nigga best friend?
She eventually did.
Oh!
As soon as she kissed him, she like the next visit, she had the divorce papers. Like, she has to move on. Basically, she has to move on.
What?
So my question is, like, how long do you expect your bitch to ride with you if you know you innocent?
Oh, I gotta let my hoe go, man. Don't wait for me. Like, I'm type nigga, I take that ill. You know what I'm saying?
Are you for real?
You got to, bro. Think about it. You're going to go crazy in that motherfucking pen, bro. Think about a bitch. Think about it, bro. You think about how she love you so much, bro. But then somebody come send you a kite or some quick little shit. And you be like, man, she out here fucking up, sucking dick everywhere, nigga. And you done out here, bro, in them pen. You lose your motherfucking mind. So you got to let that bitch go. When you gone away from the world, you got to let that shit, all the world shit, go.
I mean, at the end of the day, bro, like, a nigga still could hit you with some info.
You gotta let all your world shit go, bro. When you go to the pen, like, you ain't in the world. Niggas too grown.
Niggas. I hope you got that on camera.
Whoever y'all, keep talking.
But yeah, like I'm saying, bro, when you in the pen, bro, if you know you going away for some for life shit, then the name of the show is called For Life. So he know he had a number hidden, right?
Yeah. It was
basically
it was
a
life sentence, but it was long.
So all right.
DJ said
nigga threw a touchdown on
in
my
the
shit.
Adapter. DJ said it was a life sentence because we couldn't hear him because he wasn't talking into the microphone.
For sure. So my nigga hit him with a life. Some judge hit him with some foolishness. So
that's
okay.
It. That's
so
not it.
We cool. So at the same time, bro, I'm not finna let my chick. I'm not finna let my chick be out here trying to be missing me like that. I'm like, girl, baby, go ahead and do what you gotta do. I respect it if you gonna fuck on the niggas. Like, it's got to be, you gotta be real like that. You can't be selfish like that,
bro. I'm selfish. I'm not doing that shit. You gotta help me to fuck. Oh, my bad. Because,
let's gonna be real, bro. All niggas fucking in jail, bro. All them niggas is fucking, fool. Like, let's go and cut it the book. All them niggas is fucking, bro. You don't get out of jail and don't fuck no booty.
Allegedly,
dog.
He wasn't fucking any booty.
Man, that's bullshit, dog.
But peep this.
Wait, time out. So you mean to tell me you go to prison?
You fucking booty?
I ain't going to jail. I'll die before I go to jail. I'll die, bro. Like, I will die.
Hold on.
Y'all niggas ain't never got to worry about me snitching. I ain't never going to snitch on niggas because I'm going to be dead before they get me there, bro. I'm not going to the jailhouse.
Hold up.
Nigga, you know how much I weigh?
Hold up.
I am a little nigga, bro.
So you ain't.
I just talk shit.
So, so you.
2-3 niggas come at me, bro. I'm gonna hurt. I'm gonna try to hurt my one, and then 3 to 4 of y'all niggas, bro. I can't fuck around, bro. I'm dead, bro. I'm dying out here, nigga. I ain't going to jail. All
right.
Y'all ain't gotta worry about me, fool.
What's the question?
If the shit go down, mm-hmm. I kill myself.
Do you expect your chick to wait on you too? Cause he's fighting it. He's getting doing his appeals and shit.
No, I don't expect her to wait. I want her to, and if she does, that's cool.
Okay, well then this.
Love ain't that strong.
Because all y'all talking about, y'all just gonna cut her off.
I'm not saying I'm gonna cut her off.
No, but you're saying you're letting her go. You're letting her be with the world. So my question is, do you expect to at least have enough respect for you not to be with your homie?
Yes. Yes, I expect it not to be somebody that I call my brother. I expect it not to be somebody who was out there doing the shit that got me in.
Because this nigga had a burner. He talked to 3 people every night. Mm. His daughter, his wife, and his best fucking friend.
And they all
and y'all in
house.
The same house.
He texted all 3.
I could have just called one phone.
I'm not even gonna lie.
Check this out, man.
I might damn near, in the most non-homo way possible, I might damn near go as far as selling my motherfucking body to have a nigga with some strings go put a hit out on this best friend of mine that's fucking my wife and raising my daughter now.
Time out.
Check it, bro. If you
time out. That nigga gotta go. Skirt.
Skirt. Ain't nothing worth my butt.
Nothing worth my booty, huh?
DJ.
Not a guy.
This is hypothetical. I'm not trying to go to prison.
My ass.
I'm just saying, my nigga. That nigga gotta go. Somebody gotta kill
just
this
say
nigga.
You would go Kaiser Sose.
Ain't shit.
To get that nigga killed.
Or somebody gotta kill this nigga.
Nah. My somebody man
gotta,
is not for sale.
Somebody gotta kill this nigga, bro. You were my right hand man, and you're now fucking my wife, my nigga.
Here's my thing.
And raising my daughter. You gotta go.
But you know what? I feel it. That nigga do need to go. But you know what? You gotta look at it from a player's perspective. You get a free pass. This nigga done took your family, bro. Fuck him. You know what I'm saying? You get it. Like, your wife was a bitch now, right? She done left you for your best friend. That's some hoe ass shit. You should never do it, right? Because niggas wouldn't fuck. Like, if your bitch went to jail, right?
Your tables were turned.
I'm not finna take her motherfucking homegirl and be like, that's my new wife now. No, what the fuck is that, bitch? You in here. You know what I'm saying? Niggas ain't gonna do that shit.
Got more respect.
But a bitch will do that shit because they need that security. You know what I'm saying? So if he was my right hand man and he was handling shit, then I'm gonna go to fuck with this nigga because he was handling shit too. It's like fucking with my man.
You in the hospital. There's a lot of niggas you could have found security with.
Exactly. But here's my situation, you know what I'm saying, going into it, bro. I would take that opportunity, be like, man, you know what? Fuck that shit. I get a new look on life. This nigga gonna take my old work and my old motherfucking baby. I ain't gotta know that bitch or the motherfucking mama no more. Fuck them all. You get to go to a new life.
Wait, stop.
He gave you a new mama.
You can't call your daughter that bitch.
Are you saying that
people? She gonna be just like her mama at that point.
The daughter was still reaching out to her daddy every day. The daughter don't like the nigga. She don't fuck with that nigga at all.
Let's have this conversation.
She don't fuck with that nigga at all.
She don't.
Let's have this conversation.
Like, at all.
I thought the daughter was like young.
No,
she was little back then.
By the time they started kissing and shit, the daughter was like in middle school. She was like, I don't fuck with you, nigga. And now she in high school and she's still like, I'm trying to get my daddy out of prison.
Okay, well, cool. Okay, well, you ain't got to abandon everybody. But I was like abandon ship, nigga. I don't give a fuck. We jump off the motherfucking astronaut plane, motherfucker.
Let's have this conversation. Okay. For everybody in here, you get 30 years.
You only gotta do 15. Maybe 12.
Y'all niggas.
No,
y'all
you get 30 straight up.
No, you're not doing 30.
They don't give little niggas that much time, so I'm straight.
You're not doing the full 30.
Nah.
You're never doing the full 30.
Okay, then fine. If you're doing half of it, you get 100 years.
100
years. They try to say you murdered somebody.
Big.
They're trying to give you.
That's basically life.
99. Because that's life.
Basically, it is life, yeah.
99. Big to the deal. To the last.
Life without the possibility of parole?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. What changes? Who don't you want to come and see you?
Everybody, nigga, y'all fuck me. Get away from me. Go
yeah,
away.
I don't want nobody to see me.
Leave me alone.
If I'm doing that kind of time,
I don't want
don't
anybody.
Come visit me.
I don't care if I'm doing a week. Don't come and see me because you're going to make this day longer. Because the thing is, I spent the morning getting ready for this. And after you leave, my day is going to be ruined. Don't come and see me. Don't write me. I'm going to be out when I be out. When I get out, I'm coming straight home. Like, live your life. Do what you got to do. Just that's the thing that makes me think, like, you need to keep it to where people remember you, kind of. Like,
what?
You need to do memorable shit.
Nigga.
Because I'm not. What if you're not always there? What if you got to go away for a little bit? You got to sit down for a second.
Nigga, if the judge give me 100, I'm in the jail going straight insane, bro. Like, I'm in solitary confinement, bro. Like, I'm a whole new person. I'm telling, like, nigga, niggas, I don't come back over here, bro. Y'all don't know me no more, bro. I'm that nigga that's killing niggas in jail and shit, bro. All
right, man. All right, I feel y'all.
I want some Mad Max shit in that hole, bro.
Really? Yeah, I ain't selling my butt.